Dear participants, first of all, I would like to welcome everyone and many thanks to organizing committee. I'm Shehnaz Şener and I am a researcher on hydrogeology and earth science at Süleyman Demirel University. And today I would like to talk to you about our study titled Exploration of Geothermal Potential Using Integrated Fuzzy Logic and Analytic Hierarchy Process in the Ağrı Estrin, Turkey. The demand for energy is increasing day by day worldwide due to population growth, industrialization, and rising living standards. Geothermal energy, one of the alternative energy sources, is preferred in terms of providing environmentally friendly, quality, and regular energy. Geothermal energy is frequently used today in energy, heating and cooling process, where electrical productions and district heating and cooling applications are required. In addition, it's used in some industrial applications required drying in the productions of the chemicals, such as fertilizers, lithium, hydrogen and carbon dioxide. In the tourism sectors and in the production of mineral drinking waters. The most important advantage of geothermal is that it's a renewable energy source, and at the same time it is a clean energy source as it is natural. Countries around the world are turning to alternative energy source in order to meet the energy needed by the rapidly increasing population and developing industry. Our country is a rich geothermal resource potential, but there are still many unexplored geothermal resources. And in Turkey, comprehensive research are carried out to discover geothermal resource, which are renewable energies source that can replace conventional energy resource and to find the maximum utilization ways from them. In Turkey, since the 1960, about 460 geothermal fields have been discovered in our country. Considering the diversity in the geological structure of the country, it is seen that geothermal resources are located in certain regions and geothermal systems developed due to young tectonic and volcanic activities. Turkey's geothermal resources are particularly intense in Western Anatolia. The graben systems developed in Western Anatolia have high temperature geothermal areas of our country. This is followed by Central Anatolia, Marmara, Eastern Anatolia, Southeastern Anatolia, Black Sea, and also Mediterranean regions. In contrast to the geothermal areas in Western Anatolia, there are areas in the low and medium temperature category in Central and Eastern Anatolia. Geothermal exploration activities are very complex process that required many parameters such as faults, lithological properties, hot springs, limits, surface land temperature, etc. And you should evaluate these parameters together. In this content, especially geographic information systems-based multi-criteria decision analysis provide efficient results. It is possible to determine the potential of very large areas in a short time and also economically. GIS-based multi-criteria decision-making analysis are used by different researchers in exploration of geothermal resource in our country, as well as in the world. And what we did aim for in this study. Firstly, I want to talk about one project. It was conducted by Serka in 2014. Within the scope of the Mineral Waters Research Project in the Ağrı. 37 geothermal resource and or natural mineral water resource were identified with this project. And these resources are five well and 32 natural resources. 12 of the locations are geothermal springs and 25 of them are natural mineral springs. The most important geothermal field in the study area is located in Diyadin and its surroundings. The main purpose of this study is to determine potential geothermal resources outside of the known field in the region. The fact that no study has been carried out using this method to determine the geothermal potential of the region until today increases the importance of present study. In here, the location map of the study area is seen. Ağrı province is located in eastern Anatolia of Turkey. And the mountains covering a large part of the Ağrı province are generally seen as raw mountains. The Büyük Ağrı, Küçük Ağrı, Süphan and Köse Dağ mountains are the important heights in the region. And also a non-tendering mountain, which is known as the most active volcano in our country. The largest river in the study area is Murat River, and which is one of the main branches of the Fırat River. And in here, the geological map of the study area. And as you've seen, the geological structure of the study area is complex due to active tectonic and volcanic activities. And there are a lot of units are outcropped in the region. In here, the oldest rock units in the study area are Paleozoic and Lower Mesozoic age mica schists, kalk schists, and marbles metamorphics. The ophiolitic complex emplaced over these units by tectonic contact. This complex contains clastic rocks derived from volcanics and together with serpentine, gabbro, diabase, radiolarite, sandstone and limestone units. Upper Cretaceous volcano sedimentary units consist of metatuff and split type veta volcanics. These units are observed in the narrow areas between Diyadin and Doğubayazıt. Upper Cretaceous limestones are mapped in the north of the Diyadin. The sedimentary sequences overlying these units in the Eocene, Lower Miocene flysch, which is consists of sandstone, claystone, limestone, conglomerate, marl, and upper Miocene clastics and volcanics, which are laterally and vertically transitive with each other, consist of tuff, sandstone, limestone, claystone, agglomerate, basalt, and andesite units. In eastern Anatolia, the upper Miocene starts with sandstone, siltstone, conglomerate, and continues with clayey limestones, tuff, agglomerate, and volcanic flows. Paleocene andesites are observed in the south of the Taşlıçay and Paleocene basalts are observed in the south of Hamur. Paleocene clastics and pyroclastics were mapped around Tutak in a wide areas. And there are some travertine formations in the Paleocene limestones observed in Diyadin region. Plioquaternary andesite and basalt are observed in the wide areas in the study area. Plioquaternary pyroclastics consisting of andesite, tuff and agglomerates were mapped in the narrow areas in the east of the study area and in the southwest of the Taşlıçay. And quaternary alluviums overlie the these all units. If we look at in point of view the geothermal, Pasvanoğlu and Güler states that the reservoir rock of the geothermal systems in the region was formed by Paleozoic, Mesozoic marbles and lacustrine limestones within the Miocene, Pliocene age terrestrial clastics and carbonate rocks. Paleozoic, Mesozoic schists formed the impermeable boundary at the bottom of the reservoir rock. The cup rock of the geothermal system consists of Upper Miocene, Pliocene and Quaternary age dacitic and rheodacitic composition proplastics and lavas, basaltic lapilli tuffs and hydrogeologically impermeable units such as claystone, marl and shale in the Miocene, Pliocene age terrestrial clastics. And due to north-south comparison and intensive tectonism, fracture aquifers may be formed within the volcanic rocks. And now I want to give some information Diadin geothermal field in the region. Diadin geothermal field is located between Göbekan, Dibekli Ulukent, Mollakara, Kuşburnu, Taşkesen, Rahmankulu and Aşağı Tütek village in the south and east of the Diadin. Geothermal resource has developed in relation to the active tectonic structure of the region. The wells are artesian type and their depths is between 77 and 215 meter, and water seven temperature range of 70 and 80 degree Celsius. In here some photos are shown in the screen. And firstly, MT-98-1 and MT-98-2 boreholes were drilled in the region. In potentially high locations determined the geothermal exploration studies by General Directorate of Mineral Exploration and Research in 1997. MT-98-1 well was drilled in 129 meter depth, and while the MT-98-2 well was drilled at 77 meter depth. 150 liter per second thermal water was taken from the well numbered MT-98-1 by artesian. And then four more wells were drilled in here. The water temperature of these wells vary between 62 degrees Celsius and 78 degrees Celsius, and well flow rates between 6 and 150 liters per second. There are many hot waters, mineral water and cold water resources in the Diadin geothermal area. It is stated that the Diadin geothermal area, which has a total flow of 750 liters per second, is very suitable for various industrial applications such as central heating, greenhouse cultivation, thermal tourism, fish farming and carbon dioxide, and also dry ice productions. And in addition, 2,000 houses have been heated by geothermal in Ağrı as of 2021.
Son 5 dakika Şehnaz Hanım.
Okay. In here, the flow chart of the methodology is seen. In present study in the region, geothermal potential exploration of the Ağrı province was performed using GIS-based fuzzy analytic hierarchy process method, which is the multi-criteria decision analysis. Five different criteria were determined, taking into consideration the characteristics of the study area and also international literature. These are land surface temperature map, Neumann map, alteration zones, hot or mineral springs, and geological map. In here, land surface temperature, Neumann's and alteration zone maps was obtained from satellite image Landsat, and hot mineral springs are determined locally, and geological map is obtained from the General Directorate of Mineral Exploration and Research. Fuzzy analytic hierarchy process method, Chang has developed a new approach in solving the fuzzy analytic hierarchy process by using the triangular fuzzy numbers. And in here, you can see pair-wise comparison of the this method. And below the pay raise comparison matrix are prepared for using five criteria. And the weight values, which is indicate the importance of the geothermal potential, the weight values were determined. Firstly, the pay raise comparison matrices are prepared only for five criteria, and then pay raise comparison matrices are created for each sub-criteria. And the total weights are derived by multiplying the weights of criteria and sub-criteria as seen in table. These are criteria and obtained max belongs to the criteria. In here, hot mineral springs are evidence that directly points to the potential of geothermal resource. And for this reason, the locations of hot mineral water points in the study area were determined and the distance from these springs were evaluated. And then geologic formations, geologic and hydrologic features of the region also important. In order for the geothermal resource to form, there must be a heating source, a reservoir rock, and also cap rock that can retain heat. In geothermal resource exploration, the most important clue is the areas where these cap rock outcrops on the surface. Land surface temperature map obtained from the satellite images. These are most widely used remote sensing platforms in determining the land surface temperature is Landsat, which is operated by NASA. Lineamen zones are one of the main mechanism controlling the moving the heated fluid in the depth of the ground. In fact, the rise of the this thermal water to the surface develops along these fracture zones. And for this reason, it's extremely important for the determination of geothermal resource. It has been analyzed as one of the most important criteria in many geothermal resource exploration studies conducted in the literature, and it has been determined that the geothermal potential is high in areas close to these fracture zones. And in present study, Lineamen was evaluated, created buffer zones of the around the these Lineamen zones. Hydrothermal alteration zones are the important and great criteria in geothermal resource exploration. The chemical and mineralogical phase change that occurs as a result of interaction of the rocks with the hot fuels and circulating in them are defined as hydrothermal alteration. Especially the alteration zones observed on the surface are interpreted as an indicator of the upward movement of the hot fuels in the depths of the ground. And in this study, hydrothermal alteration zones map was prepared with the aid of the Landsat satellite image.
Toparlayabilir miyiz Sehnaz
Hanım? Okay. And then geothermal potential index was calculated using this formula. After the index values were calculated, four different classes, such as very high, high, medium, and low favorable geothermal areas were determined for the study area. And I pass this. In here, the hot mineral springs map is seen, and the buffer zones were created for the mineral springs. These weights are obtained using the fuzzy analytic hierarchy process. And according to calculations, the highest weight value belongs to the buffer of the 0 and 2500. But the lowest weight value is belong to the buffer of greater than the 10,000 meter. In the geologic formations, lithologic units identified as the reservoir and cap rocks within the previous studies in the region. And in here, indicator areas and other areas were determined and weighted with fuzzy analytic hierarchy process. Hydrothermal alteration zones map like the geological properties, indicator areas and the other areas were determined and weighted with fuzzy analytic hierarchy process. For the limits, the buffer zones were created and weighted like the hot mineral springs. And land surface temperature map was obtained with the aid of the Landsat satellite image. In here, temperatures vary between 55.04 degrees Celsius at minus 0.23 degrees Celsius. And four different classes were evaluated and weighted with the fuzzy. And final step, the geothermal potential index map was computed using the map calculation functions of the ArcGIS and also overlay analysis of selected criteria mentioned above. The calculated geothermal potential index is between 0.117 and 0.618. The quantitative classification method was used to determine geothermal potential classes, such as very high, high, medium, and low in the study area. In the map, the red color indicates the high potential for the geothermals, and the percentage of these classes are shown in the slide. In here, the sort of Diadin, the vicinity and northwest of Doğubayazıt, around and east of Tutak, the southeast of Patmos, the vicinity and southwest of Eleşkirt have been identified as areas with high geothermal. And it's observed that the areas determined as having high geothermal potential are compatible with the existing geothermal areas in the region. I don't want to repeat again the conclusions because of times. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much, Şehnaz Hanım. It was really interesting. I would like to ask you one question. I mean, I would appreciate if you can reply quite fast. What is the advantage of this methodology that we are using comparing the others before utilized?
This method is in a short time and economically we have some preliminary findings about the regions. And it's of course only first step for the geothermal research and explorations, and then many researches should be performed, geophysic, about geological and geochemical, hydrogeological, etc. But it is give some informations about the large areas in a short time and also economically.
Okay, thank you very much. So we can, let's say, utilize this in the preliminary studies if we have also some data collected to have a quick idea.
Yes.
Definitely if you would like to go for deeper exploration studies or not.
Yes, I know.
Great, thank you very much. Now
there is one more question in the Q&A section, Dr. Bozkurt.
Oh, my apologies.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, the question is, how reliable is using Landsat data for alteration mapping?
In fact, this is my partner, Erhan Şener, was done the remote sensing applications, so I can't explain in now.
Thank you very much. I think we can later on provide answers to the questions. But based on a recent study that I'm involved, I can just say that nowadays the Landsat data has reached a dreamy world that you have in various resolutions can have data, so they can be really reliable when you are using them in your studies. But it depends the specs and where have you, from where you have collected the data itself. So most probably in this study, which was collected, was having some high resolution data. So it provides really very significant promising areas, and you have chance to correlate them with developed manifestations.
Yes.
Thank you very much again for your presentation. It was very insightful. Now I would like...